Hi DIYers, Sterling with Alarm Grid here. Today we're going to show you how to install a Kwikset Smart Code 914 touchpad electronic lock, which is Z-Wave enabled, to our 2 gig Go control panel. This Kwikset lock is a push button lock on the outside. It's a deadbolt on the inside, and with access for Z-Wave technology, it allows you to control your lock from your 2 gig Go control panel. And with the proper service through your monitoring company, you will even be able to control your lock remotely from the web or a mobile device. So a really, really cool way to add added functionality to your 2 gig Go control and automate your home with lights, locks, and thermostats. In this case, we're doing a lock. So we've got our Kwikset installed at our door, and the key portion of that is the actual internal lock portion. To pair the Z-Wave lock, you need to be within 12 inches of this system. So the question will be, how do I get power to my lock if it's in my door, remote from my panel? Do I have to bring my panel to the lock? That's one option. Or Kwikset is nice and they've given us a little temporary battery compartment that we can install to provide power to this unit, so that we can pair the Z-Wave portion right to here, then we can pop our batteries out, take it back over, take it back over to the door and plug it in, and we will know that it will be paired to the panel. You would of course want to verify that it works over at the door location since we're pairing it here, but Z-Wave range, typically for a lock we recommend no more than 30 feet, unless you're using other Z-Wave devices to repeat out to the lock. That's how a Z-Wave network works. It actually, every node on the network will act as a repeater. So if your door was farther than 30 feet, you just have to have another Z-Wave in between to get range out to the door. So now that we've reviewed how the Kwikset lock works and what you can do with this Z-Wave enabled lock, we're going to show you how to connect and pair it to your system. So when you have your 2 gig Go control, it is Z-Wave ready. If you were to hit services and then Z-Wave, you'll see this message. Now this message says that the feature Z-Wave control is not currently activated, and it'll tell you to call your installing dealer. Of course, with the DIY, you are the installing dealer, so to enable Z-Wave functionality in the panel, you do need to have a cellular communicator that has the actual firmware for Z-Wave functionality in the panel. In our case, we have the alarm.com CDMA communicator installed in our unit. So we have everything we need hardware-wise, we just have to turn on the feature in the panel. So we do security, menu, and toolbox, just like we always do for programming. We need our installer code, which is 1561, unless we've changed it. And we hit the right arrow twice to get to installer toolbox. From installer toolbox, we want to hit system configuration, and now we're into our programming. On the 2 gig Go control, everything's question based, and for our case we want to jump to question number 79, which is the Z-Wave question. So we do Go to 79, and we can see select Z-Wave feature 0 to 3. It's default on 1, which is disabled but visible. That means Z-Wave is not enabled or turned on. That's why when we pressed the button we saw that message. But it is visible, so we were able to see the button. If for some reason you wanted to disable the option to even see Z-Wave, you could go disabled and hidden. Now you can't see Z-Wave and you don't even see the option that Z-Wave is enabled. What we want is enabled on panel, remote access disabled would allow us to do a Z-Wave lock control from the 2 gig Go control, but if we didn't have a service plan that included automation, then we would want to leave it disabled. If you're monitored through Alarm Grid, all of our plans, alarm.com service plans, will include automation. So you want to make sure you're choosing option number 3 so you can control your lock from the panel and you can control it from your alarm.com access. So you'll notice enabled on panel, rules disabled, and remote access enabled. One point here, different than the Honeywell systems, is that, or the Lynx Touch Honeywell systems anyways, is that when you enable remote Z-Wave control, you no longer can program your Z-Wave scenes and rules at the panel. You have to do it through the interface on the alarm.com website or app, because that is the way you set up your functionality to tell the lock when to activate based on different system functions. If you were to do the enabled on panel with remote access disabled, you're saying, I'm not gonna have alarm.com remote home automation option, so therefore allow me to set up scenes and rules within the system. In our case, this system is monitored with an alarm.com service plan. With alarm grid, we always allow you to do automation with that service plan, so we're gonna choose option number 3. We wanna then advance to the next question. You'll see select Z-Wave switches. That would be for lights, dimmers, switches. Down arrow again is thermostats, and finally door locks. So once you have the Z-Wave globally turned on, the next one is which aspect of Z-Wave, lights, locks, or thermostats are you gonna be using? In our case, we wanna enable the lock feature. And if we hit the down arrow, now we're to the next screen, and we've locked in the two questions we need to pair our Z-Wave Kwikset lock to our 2GIG Go control. So again, it was question number 79 to globally turn it on, and question number 82 to turn on the lock subset of the Z-Wave. Now that we have that in there, we're gonna hit end. Anytime we've made a programming change in a 2GIG Go control, once we make the change, this will be default to save changes, and it'll give you a summary in case you made any other programming changes to review everything, and we want to hit exit to lock in our settings. If this is the first time programming on a 2GIG Go control and you've used other all-in-one wireless systems, don't be alarmed that the screen goes dark. That's by design. So as soon as you've done your programming change, if you ever go into programming and make any kind of change and save it, you're going to get this reboot action. If you don't make a change, you can uncheck that save, and then you would come out of here without rebooting the system. But in this case, we wanted to lock that change in so that we can now pair our lock to our system. So we're just waiting for it to boot up. It just said system disarmed, ready to arm. So we know a few seconds later, we're going to have our screen again. So now that we have Z-Wave enabled, if we hit services and then Z-Wave, instead of the message about contacting your company, you now have the ability to set up your doors and locks. The rules are disabled, your scenes are available. So you can turn your scene on, but the rules about when will that scene activate, again, we're doing that from our alarm.com service. Because we did locks, we're actually seeing the option for locks. Nothing's in there yet because we haven't paired it. Any Z-Wave unit can only be paired to one Z-Wave controller. So we don't know, was this paired to something in factory? Was this something that was paired and returned and back? If it's always recommended that before you try to add it, you first just remove it. So remove device, press the learn button, which is the A alpha button on the device, within 12 inches. A device has been removed from another network. So now we know, in case this unit had ever been used with any other Z-Wave controller, we've now removed it, and it should be able to be paired now to this unit. So we hit back to get out of the remove section, and we add a device. And again, it's the A learn button. The light lights up. Very quickly, we see device discovered. And we want to leave this here for a full 60 seconds at least. We actually like to recommend leaving it up to a couple minutes just to make sure that it fully pairs and it's gotten a good connection between the device and the Z-Wave lock and the Go control panel. So we're going to leave this, try not to move it at all, and certainly not move it more than a foot away from the 2GIG Go control panel. You can see it says querying device information, so it's just kind of establishing its network here. Once it is established, we'll have to remove the batteries so that we can install the Z-Wave lock, reinsert the batteries, and like we described earlier, we just want to make a test inside the door to make sure it's working. Here we go. Secure keypad door lock shows on node number 2. There's 232 available nodes on the Z-Wave network, so it just joined the next available. And it's calling it a Black & Decker ID 1 out of 1. Please configure the locks with keypad codes for each user by selecting each lock in the door lock screen, then pressing the code button. So now that we've added our lock, if we go back into doors and locks, we can see that we have our included Z-Wave lock showing on the screen. If we highlight the lock we just included, we can see that it acquires the status of the device, shows our battery levels 100%, door is unlocked, and if it was installed, you could test it here. So now we're going to install this back into the door, and we can then, as a final step, make sure it is able to be controlled from the panel. So now that we have programmed our Kwikset 914 Z-Wave lock to our 2GIG Go control, and we've taken the Z-Wave unit with the batteries and reinstalled in the actual lock in the door, we're going to go ahead and check to make sure that we have good range back to the panel. So we hit services, Z-Wave, and doors and locks. We can see that we have our lock showing, and if we highlight it, it's going to acquire the status of the device. If we're out of range, we could get a failure message here, in which case we'd have to implement a light switch or a dimmer switch or a plug-in Z-Wave module here between here and the door to get the signal strength better out to the lock, or perhaps, let's say, right behind this wall there's an AC unit, metal ductwork. Perhaps you put a switch off to the right side, which would then pass the signal to the lock instead of going directly through the metal, which is something that will severely limit a Z-Wave network range. So, luckily ours was well within range, came up fairly quickly. We can see that our door is unlocked, our battery is at 100%, and it timed out, but if we go back in, so we can see that its door is unlocked, battery 100%, and let's test it. Sending Z-Wave command to the door lock. Please wait. Door is unknown. I can hear the motor actually going on the lock right now. Door is now locked. So we have successfully controlled our door lock remotely from our 2GIG Go control panel. Last step, we always recommend renaming your Z-Wave device. If you don't name them, you'd have to remember that all it said was Black & Decker out of the box. So if we're going to have multiple locks in the house, you'd have to have a list of Black & Decker node 2 is front door, and you know, Yale whatever is front back door. In this case, we can just go ahead and type. Front door. Lock it in there and save it. And now we have our door lock named front door. So if we're going to be using our 2GIG Go control panel, or we're going to be using our alarm.com mobile app, we would know, okay, very clearly, we're going to be controlling our front door. So we hope you've enjoyed this video on how to program your Kwikset 914 Z-Wave door lock to your 2GIG Go control panel. We invite you to subscribe to our channel, and if you have any questions about pairing your Z-Wave lock to your 2GIG Go control, please email support@alarmgrid.com.